thank God for everybody, hallelujah, that has sacrificed your time to chime in, to tune in with us at the Power Hour Prophetic Encounter, amen. Our guest speaker today is Apostle Michael McDuff, amen, from Leesburg, Georgia. He is the pastor of Kingdom Life Fellowship Ministries, amen. So we bless the Lord for him being able to release a rhema word to us on tonight. So at this time, amen, can we get a selection, amen, from Minister Rosa? Can you bless us with a short selection, please, so that the man of God will fulfill himself, amen.
Amen. I want to be a follower of Christ. I want to be one of his disciples. I want to walk in the newness of life. So let me be a follower of Christ. What do I have to do? Where do I have to stay? How do I have to walk each and every day? Tell me what does it cost if I carry the cross? So let me be a follower of Christ. Jesus, 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 you never gave up on me. Jesus, 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 you gave your life that I might be free. Jesus, 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 you never gave up on me. You, Jesus, I thank you, Lord. Jesus, 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 you never gave up on me. Jesus, 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 you gave your life that I might be free. Jesus, 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 you never gave up on me. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Lord.
Amen. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. So at this time, I'm going to introduce Apostle Michael McDuffie. Amen. From Leesburg, Georgia. Amen. He is the pastor of Kingdom Life Fellowship Ministries. Amen. And we bless the Lord. From Justice, I believe, amen, and residing, amen, in Albany or Leesburg, Georgia. So we thank God for him. We can call him a homeboy. He's from our area, Southeast Georgia, amen. And we have Southeast Georgia that's on the line supporting him as well. So we just thank God that he was available, amen. This is the month of the apostles for our conference line, amen. This is the month of our apostles, January. First fruit, amen. So we want the apostles to speak and to devour the ground, amen, on this conference line so that souls will be saved in this year, amen. We already have one, amen. So say through the conference line, amen. So God is doing some awesome things, and we want him to continue, amen, to move upon this line. So we're letting the apostles speak in January. Next month will be the prophets, amen. So we thank God for none other than Apostle Mike McDuffie, amen, from Leesburg, Georgia. We have the line, Apostle.
Praise the Lord. I want to give God praise and glory and honor, first of all, for this day, because this is the day that he has made. And I want to thank God, amen, for prophet and apostle, amen, allowing me to come and to share. But I do believe that God is saying in this hour. And also I want to say thank God for all of the warriors and the servants and the ones that God have on the line on tonight that is standing in the gap, that's on the wall, that's in the battlefield. Amen. As I've been meditating and seeking God concerning after I got the invitation to be on this call, amen, that what God would have for me to say this night, I began, the Holy Spirit began to deal with me and began to let me know that we're in a season now that we're during this time of the year, we know that where people is making new resolution and people's talking about doing new things, people's talking about going into a new thing and doing new things today and going forward. But what he began to deal with me about, that in this season of God, this is what he's calling us to, that before we can go forward, we must go back. And what I'm talking about, going back to what? Going back to Pentecost. That's right, going back to Pentecost. Going back to an experience with God. I began to look in the Word of God in the books of Acts. And we know the books of Acts deal with us about the Acts of the Apostles, the Acts will deal with us about the birthing of the church, deal with us about the outpouring of the Holy Ghost. And I began to look in the book of Acts, amen, and it look in verse chapter 3, and we want to look at verse 1. It began to say that Peter and John went up together in the temple at the hour of prayer, being in the ninth hour. We know that the Jews at that time, they had three different prayer times. They had a 9 a.m. prayer, they had a 12 p.m. prayer, and they had a 3 p.m. prayer. And that being the last prayer hour of the day. And we are in the time now that we are in the last hour of the day. We're not no longer living in the last days, but we're living in the last hour. Jesus said that in the last hour, I will come when you know not of. And so we're living in the last hour, and it is very important in this season and in this day that we go back to Pentecost. We go back to the experience of having the power of God. It's no more about your titles. It's no more about being a Bible total. Now it's about fruit. That's what God wants now. He wants fruit. He said for us to be fruitful and multiply. But before we can multiply, we must have fruit. And the fruit that he wants us to produce in this hour, that is soul. That's what it's about. It's about soul. Many that's on this land are here, probably read this passage over and over again. And in verse 6 is really what stand out to me. It tells us in verse 6, it says, then Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give unto thee in the name of Jesus Christ. Rise up and walk. We're living in a time now that people are more concerned about their flesh and about what they can get from God than having a real true relationship with God. Peter said, silver and gold I have not. But we live in a day now that we say we have the silver, we have the gold, we have the bling bling, we have the prosperity. We have dealing injustice to the people of God. We have dealing injustice to the world because we have made prosperity as our base message and not the benefit of salvation. Prosperity is one of the benefits, but it's not the base. Prosperity is not about how much money that you have, how much money that you get, or how God can be your sugar daddy. But it's really about being a blessing to others. And it's a benefit. It's not the base. The base of it is repentance. The base of it is changing our heart towards God, towards sin and getting closer to God. That's the basis of it. And in this season that we got to have the power of God. What I mean by we got to go back to Pentecost, we got to go back to, first of all, accountability. I heard a great man of God talk about that a few weeks ago. Pastor Willie Williams from Atlanta began to tell us about accountability. We first, as leaders, we first, as the people of God, we got to be accountable. We got to be walking in the place of a light. We got to be walking in an example. We got to be representing who God is in this season and in this hour. The Word of God tells us that we have this power, this treasure in earthen vessel, that the excellence of the power shall not be of us, but of God, that people shall be able to look upon us and see who God is, because we are walking epistles, that we should be able to be read by people, and we must have an intimate personal relationship with God. It's not about anymore just being a part of a church, but we got to become the church. We got to become the manifestation who God is. So we got to go back to Pentecost. We got to go back to the time of crying out before God, laying in his presence, until we be endowed with power. We're living in a time now that in the church as a whole, not every church, but in the church as a whole, that we are in a powerless generation. We don't have power that when people come and they need help, that they can't get help. Peter preached one message, and the Bible tells us that 3,000 souls got saved. He began to preach, and he tells them, first of all, he said, repent. The word of God tells us that he told them to repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. Repent. That's something we don't hear people talk about today. We want to tell people how God understands. We want to give them a 12-step plan. We want to take them through different series, but we must bring them back to repentance. Repentance is the base of what God desires. We must repent. What is repent? First of all, that word re is a prefix. It means to redo. Other words, that what we was doing, the way we was going, was not correct. That was the wrong way to go. So we got to redo what? We got to repent. Pent comes from the word penthouse, which is how you're living. For me to get to a higher place, for me to get to a different level, for me to go to another place in God, I must change my way. The basic definition of insanity is doing the same thing but expecting something different. I'll say that again. Doing the same thing over and over again, but expecting something different. This season and this hour, for us to have something different, we must repent. We must give our heart back to God. We must get back in the place that God called us to be. It's the season that we are in now. We are in this season now that we must have a relationship with God. The Bible tells us in the book of Acts, it tells us in Acts 3:19, it says, and repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sin may be blotted out, when the time of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Let me read that in the Amplified Version. The Amplified Version says, repent, change your mind and purpose. Turn around and return to God, that your sins may be erased, blotted out, wiped clean. The times of refreshing are the recovering from the effect of heat. The recovering from the effect of heat. The heat is on. The heat is on now. The heat is on because the world is crying out for something different. The world don't want just the same old, same old. They want to see the power of God. That's why we're living in a time now that when we begin to see their advertisements, the movies, like The Devil Within, like different things dealing with the supernatural. Why it's so popular now? Because the world say, I want power. And the power must be in us. It must be in the house of God because we have the answer. But we must return back to Pentecost. We must return back to where we lay and prostrate before God. We must turn back to clean living. That's the baseline. We must turn back to clean living. We must live the thing. We can't no longer talk it. We got to be about it. We got to live it. The Bible tells us in the Word of God that choose this day whom you're going to serve. If you're going to serve God, let's serve him. If you're going to serve Baal, let's serve Baal. It's time now for us to start at the head, as the people of God, as the leaders, as the apostles, as the prophets, as the pastors, as the teachers, as the evangelists, to live holy. It's time out now for us to cover it for one another. If he is wrong, the Bible tells us in the Word of God that if you find a false prophet among you, for you to take him outside the city, amen, that's stoning. I know we don't talk about doing that today, but we just can't allow people to continue to disgrace and bring reproach to the body of Christ. We must hold them in check. We must be accountable. That somebody must be able to check you, to tell you, brother, I love you, but let me pray for you because you're going wrong. And in the midst of you doing your healing, you might need to step down. You might need to step to a side because this is crucial. We're dealing with soul. We're dealing with life. We must come back to the power of God. For us to have the power of God, we got to deny ourselves. We have to go through something. Paul began to tell us in the book of Corinthians, when he began to tell us, amen, that we have this power, we have this treasure in earthly vessels. They say that the essence of the power may be of God and not of us. He began to tell us that we all got this power. It's a treasure. Anything that you realize as a treasure, you count it a great value. You really appreciate it. And amen. I think about my wife. She has some nice counter in her home. Amen. Because of the value that she has with that counter, we don't use that every day. Amen. We don't be able to eat out of that counter every day. A lot of times it is used for only display because of the value. Amen. So this is a treasure. Amen. And so as the power of God that we have in us, it is a treasure. But this power is not about us, it's about God. But to have this power, we must be able to know that we're going to be troubled on every side. We're going to be headstand. We're going to be pressed on every side. We're going to be oppressed in every way. Jesus said in his word, he said that the world is going to hate you because they hated me first. It's amazing to me that today that we have so many that profess the name of Christ, but the world feels so comfortable around them. One thing about us going back to the power of the Holy Ghost, that when we have the power of the Holy Ghost, there isn't a conflicting, there isn't a conviction agent in the power of the Holy Ghost. I cannot say that I have the Holy Ghost and be comfortable with everything that is around me and that I see. I can continue to live alone and allow everything that I see when it brings a reproach unto who God says he really is. I'm not having the Holy Ghost because I want to match, and I'm not having the Holy Ghost because I'm just trying to get out of bed. I'm not having the Holy Ghost because I'm trying to get me a new PC helper. But I'm having the power of the Holy Ghost because, first of all, it takes that power to keep me, amen. Is that the same power that it's going to take to keep you and I? We need that Holy Ghost, amen, to enable us to be an instrument of his glory. And we need that power of the Holy Ghost to enable us to be a vessel that we can say to God that he is well pleased with us, and into the joy of the Lord. That's the testimony that we should be striving for. It's not God's will for all of us to be maker. But whatever he gave you, be maker with that. If he gave you 50, be maker with 50. If he gave you 300, be maker with 300. What I mean is that bring them into a greater intensity of the power of God. Bring them into a true relationship with God. Let them know on this journey that it's going to cost you something to live holy. It don't cost us anything to get saved. It's free. It's been paid for by the blood and the sacrifice of our Lord and Savior. But it's going to cost you something to live holy. It's going to cost you to be ostracized. It's going to cost you to be denied. It's going to cost you to be hurt and embarrassed. But if you would stay in the gap, I guarantee you, you're going to get the reward of your obedience to God. I want to encourage you tonight, amen, that we go back to Pentecost. We go back to seeking the face of God, not just the hand of God. We go back to laying out before God that we know without a shadow of a doubt that we're being endowed with power. And we go through the book of Acts. It began to let us know that there were many refillings of the experience of the Holy Ghost. You need to go every day with a dose of the Holy Ghost. You need to have an intimate relationship every day with the Holy Ghost. So often I ask my people at the church, I tell them that, how do you get dressed this morning? How do you get ready for church? Amen. You don't come to church to have church. Amen. You already the church, so you already be dressed when you come into church. And because of what God has imparted into you during your private devotion and your time with God, when we as a body, amen, get together because we have had our private devotion with God, we can be strengthened to one to another. It's time out for we as the people of God are being so separated because we don't have not only the power of God, we don't have the fruit of God, which is love. Amen. God has given all of us a task. And it's a task that we need. We need a connection of one another. We need the influence of one another. We need the strength and the help of one another. Amen. It's no thing to us to have a testimony that we as the people of God that we can't come together. We can't even come together with prayer. We can't even come together with a fast. We can't even come together going out on the street. Oh. Did I say that? That's right. We're going out on the street because that's where the souls are at. We got to go out to where the people is at. Amen. It's time out for now. for us just gathering together in our conferences and just us gathering together and us getting together and preaching to one another and making each other shout. There's people that's crying out for a difference, but they got to see a difference. But for them that have a difference, they got to see a difference. And the difference is the power of the Holy Ghost. It's not about my accolades or my degrees or even my title. It's about how much anointing, how much power, how much experience I have with God. And we must go back to Pentecost. It's time for us to really walk the walk that we've been talking. Because the world want to see. We live in a world that they are moved by images. Images dictate to how the world responds. What image that they see on the airwaves. What image that they, what they see in the papers and in the magazine, that the world is fashioned by images. So we must be the image of God. We must be the power that God desires to be resonated, and not just in the four walls, but he wants that power to be on our job. He placed you on that job because there's a soul there that needs to be delivered. He placed you in that neighborhood. It's a shame that a lot of us that profess who Christ is live in neighborhoods and we don't even know the name of our next door neighbor. We must return back to Pentecost. We must go back to where love is the foremost, where the power of God directs our life. It's not about just prosperity. It's not about how many I'm running. It's not about my membership. It's about being who God called us to be in this hour. As I say many times, the greatest calling of all is a son of God. The whole creation waiting for the manifestation of the son of God. The greatest calling of all is a son of God. And the greatest testimony of all is to be a son that God can say, this is my son in whom I am well pleased. And we all know that when we talk about sons of God, that's not gender. Amen. When we talk about sons of God, that's not gender. Amen. Because as you in God, there's neither male nor female. So even though you may be on your birth certificate as a female, but you is to God a son. You is a person that's supposed to be birthing. You're supposed to be carrying out the legacy of your father. You're supposed to be carrying out the legacy, the testimony of your father. So that's why I want to encourage us tonight. Going back to Pentecost. Going back to laboring before God. Going back to being a different. I ask you as I close on this. Your goal in 2012 should be, how many souls have I brought to the Lord in this week, in this month, in this year? In Jesus' name, God bless. Amen.